हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द फर्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ साइंस क्लास 8 चैप्टर 5 कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम। इन टुडेज मॉड्यूल वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द कोल एंड इट्स फॉर्मेशन। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस चैप्टर वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट सम एग्जॉस्टेबल नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज लाइक कोल, पेट्रोलियम, नेचुरल गैस। सो लेट गेट स्टार्टेड। स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज। The resources that are provided to us by the nature are called natural resources. For example, air, water, sunlight, coal, petroleum, and minerals. And now, let us understand the kinds of natural resources. Students, on the basis of availability of various resources in nature, natural resources can be broadly classified into two kinds. First, inexhaustible natural resources, and second, exhaustible natural resources. So let us first understand about the inexhaustible natural resources. So students, you can see around you a number of natural resources, for example sunlight, air and water, and these resources are present in nature in unlimited quantity, and such natural resources are called inexhaustible natural resources. And these natural resources cannot be completely utilized by human activities. Second is exhaustible natural resources. Students, there are some natural resources that are present in nature in very limited quantity and that can be completely utilized or completely exhausted by human activities. For example, forests, wildlife, minerals, coal, petroleum, natural gases. These resources are called exhaustible natural resources. And now come to the next topic, coal. Students, coal is a black colored stone like fuel which is used to cook food and for other different purposes. Students, coal is used as a fuel in thermal power station to produce electricity, and it is also used in many industries, and it was used as a fuel to run the steam engine till recent years. And now let us understand the formation of coal. About 300 million years ago, during the Carboniferous age, there was plenty of plant and dense forest in swampy and low-lying wetland areas on the earth. And when these plants and other life forms get died, then they drifted down to the bottom of the swamps, where they were compressed and decomposed to form peat. And the coal was formed due to the compression of that peat at high temperature and pressure. And this slow process of conversion of dead vegetation into coal is called carbonization. Now students, let us understand how we extract coal from the coal mine. So students, as we know that coal is found under the ground, and that's why it need to be extracted from the underground mining. Coal can be extracted from the coal seams either through the surface mining or underground mining. The surface mining is used when the coal is found close to the surface or hillsides, and if the coal is present in deep beneath of the earth, then it is extracted by underground mining. And student, the coal that is extracted from these mining is not in usable form, and that's why it need to be processed, and the coal is processed in industry to get useful products such as coke, coal tar, coal gas. To process the coal to get different products from it, the coal is heated strongly in the absence of air, and this process is called destructive distillation of coal. And students, let us know about the coke. What is coke? Coke is almost pure form of carbon, and coke is a porous black substance similar to coal. Students, did you know that coke is pure form of coal or carbon, and it is obtained from destructive distillation of a particular type of coal. Students, now let us know what are the use of coke. The coke is used as fuel and as reducing agent in the smelting of iron ore in the blast furnace, and it is also used in the manufacturing of steel and in the extraction of many type of metals from their ore. Now let us know about another product of coal, that is coal tar. Coal tar is a black, thick, viscous liquid, and it is a mixture of almost 100 of chemicals compound. Students, you must have seen the construction of roads. During the construction of road, a black color liquid is used to build up the road, that is coal tar. And coal tar are also used for manufacturing synthetic dyes, explosives, perfumes, drugs and plastic. Our next topic is coal gas. Coal gas is also obtained during the processing of coal to get coke. And the coal gas is mainly used as a fuel in industries around the coal processing plants. And students, now let us understand what are the use of coal. As we know, coal is a form of fuel, and so it is used to generate electricity worldwide. And coal is used to make steam for heating, which was used in steam engine of trains. Coal is also used as coke in steel making, and coal is used in manufacturing industries for heat and power applications. Now students, let us revise what we have learned today by answering the following questions. Question 1. Various materials which are obtained from nature are called natural resources. Which of the following is not a natural resource? A. Mineral. B. Water. C. Soil. D. Plastic. And your right answer is D. Plastic. Question 2. Air is a natural resource and cannot be exhausted by human activities. It is known as inexhaustible natural resource. Which of the following is another inexhaustible natural resource? A. Coal. B. Petroleum. C. Sunlight. D. Minerals. And your right answer is C. Sunlight. Question 3. Which of the following is a pair of exhaustible natural resources? A. Coal and soil. B. Air and sunlight. C. Water and petroleum. D. Wildlife and minerals. And your right answer is D. Wildlife and minerals. Question 4. Exhaustible natural resources are A. Unlimited in quantity. B. Not dependent on nature. C. Limited in quantity. D. Not exhausted by human activities. And your right answer is C. Limited in quantity. Practice makes perfect. Students, it's time to practice. And your practice homework are on your screen. Students, we will meet again with the next video of this chapter. Till then, take care and thank you for watching.